Hi, and welcome to a new video of this MOOC. In this video, we are going to see a brief introduction of Angular technology, studying the different parts that compose the architecture of an Angular application. Angular is a technology created in 2009, and that from 2012 was maintained by Google. The current version of this framework is the version number 6, and this is the version we are going to use during this MOOC. Thanks to Angular, we can develop single page applications totally in the client side. So all the model view controller pattern is included in the client part of our application. Angular is based on components. We will see with detail what a component is later. And the main features that we can say that are the dependency injection feature and the fact that an Angular application is based on a modular pattern that allows us to totally encapsulate our application in modules. Thanks to Angular, we can deploy complex applications using Mongo, Express, and Node. Node.js using what is called the mean full stack framework. The main technologies that we have to know in order to start developing our Angular applications are the following. Of course, for developing the views, we will use HTML with several extensions that Angular adds. We will use TypeScript for scripting the logic of our application. This is not mandatory, but is highly recommended. In this MOOC, we are going to use TypeScript. Of course, we can use CSS and SCSS for styling our templates. And finally, thanks to the command line interface tools that Angular offers, we will be able to manage our application. There are a set of related technologies that Angular also use in order to lint the code, to perform tests, and so on. We will see some of them also in the next videos. A very important thing we have to take into account is the difference between what is called Angular and Angular.js. When Angular released the second version of this technology, this was not a new release with some improvements. Angular 2 was a totally rewrite of the technology. So, of course, Angular 2 and Angular 1 versions of this framework were not compatible between them. Okay? The terminology that from that moment Angular used is that every release after the release 2 is now called just Angular, and the first release that is not compatible with the other is now called Angular.js. So please be careful, because when you search information or documentation about Angular in the internet, all the documentation you find regarding Angular.js is not compatible with the releases we are going to use during this MOOC. Okay, so let's take a look to an overview of the architecture of an Angular application. We can see here in the center of this figure how an Angular application is based on components. A component is a part of the application that displays a specific part and that manages the logic exclusively of this part of the application. So we have a template and the logic of the component. And in order to communicate both parts, we will use property and event bindings. Okay? Around these components, there are several parts of the application, like modules, services, directives, etc. We will see each of these parts during the next videos of this MOOC. But let's see now just a brief introduction about each of these parts of the application. As I said before, Angular applications are totally modular. And this is possible thanks to the ng module system that it provides to developers. Each application has, of course, a root module that in simple applications probably will be also the unique module in the application. But when we start developing complex applications, it's very frequent that we will need to separate our application in several modules. We can see here in this script how an application, a module, is just a simple JavaScript class with a decorator, the ng module decorator, that adds several configurations to this module. We will see with detail this in next videos. Of course, in Angular applications, we can use external libraries to add extra functionality to our logic. And the way in which we can import these libraries is this one. As you can see here, we are importing the browser module from a specific Angular library. In order to install these libraries, we can use the typical npm command as in other Node.js applications. Regarding components, as I said before, a component is a part of the application that controls exclusively this patch of the screen that is called a view. A component is defined by three files. We have a file that controls the logic, and that is a JavaScript class in which using JavaScript and TypeScript we can develop the logic of the application. We have the template that is written in HTML, and we have also the style of the component that of course is a CSS class. The class interacts with the logic through an API of properties and methods, one side and on the other side. Angular self-manages the components, updating, creating, and destroying them, following the component lifecycle that, again, we will see with detail later. Here we can see just an example of a component's logic in which we can divide the script in the logic, that is the class, a JavaScript class with a set of properties and a set of methods. And on the other hand, we have the metadata of the component that is configured using a component decorator. The template is just an HTML file that tells Angular how to render the component. And as we can see here, we are adding a set of extensions that we will study later. For managing the communication between the template and the logic, Angular uses the feature that is called data binding and allows us to communicate also components between them, okay? Parents and child components. Angular supports four types of data binding, and you can see in this figure a brief overview of this data binding feature. Directives are just an extension of the HTML that Angular provides, and that allows us to modify the way in which the templates are shown to the user. Okay, we have structural directives that alter the layout of the template, and also we have attribute directives that just modify the appearance or the behavior of an existing element in the document. Finally, a very interesting feature that Angular offers is the service feature. A service is just a JavaScript class that encapsulates a specific feature of our application. For instance, we have services for managing login, for exchanging messages between different parts of our applications, and for using these services in a component, we will take advantage of the dependency injection feature, okay? This is not all the things that Angular offers to us. We will see in the next videos also details about forms, HTTP requests, also the life cycle of the components, pipe, routing, and all the features you can see in this slide. So this is just an introduction, a brief introduction to what Angular offers to us, and we will see with detail each of these features in next videos of this MOOC. That's all, and see you in the next video. Bye.